Today, we are diving deep into agentic coding. And we are not just writing code. We are building an entire workflow how to cooperate with AI when building projects managed and developed mostly by AI. Get ready to dive it with me. There is a recent trend for so-called vibe coding, and it is great. You can easily build project only by talking with AI agent and see how it is doing most of the work. I'm also enjoying this type of coding for my small projects, and small is the keyword here. When the project is small, the developer can probably manage it alone. However, in larger projects, when the scope of the application grows, one person is not able to deliver it effectively. There are just too many details. The roles in the most of the teams in software houses are there for a reason. There are not only developers, but also an analyst and project manager. Whole team is required to successfully deliver the project. Another issue is the context length of available models. When you want to implement change in the big project, you can encounter error like this. That is why I created my personal workflow to get the most from agentic mode. Let's start with review of my current workflow, which I am using to develop local AI bench. If you don't know this project, I discussed it in my previous videos. Link is in the description. There are three main stages. First stage is to define the project, where I am gathering all my thoughts and refine them using AI until I get the complete plan. Second stage is to define technical instructions. So simply speaking, good practices for my developer agent. And the last stage is the iterative work with my agents to implement the project. So I started with creation of a short description of the application. I defined the purpose of the application and a few technical details how I want to achieve the goal, like Python as a backend programming language and Svelte on frontend side. In second step, I wanted to get more into details. I used new Claude thinking model to help me figure that out. I used this prompt. Notice how I'm framing this as a feedback for my AI agent. That is a key to getting the right kind of the response. I am asking for potential issues and improvements. Claude analyzed it and gave me some actionable points how to improve the plan. We need to review this feedback very carefully. This is the step where your control matters the most. In some cases, it might point out missing features, suggest better implementation strategies, or even identify potential problems we haven't considered. And now we start iterating. We incorporate suggestions that are worth to consider into our plan and ask again the same thing. But make sure to clear the previous context to force the model to think fresh. Of course, we can go deeper and iterate the process until you're satisfied with the number of details and final structure of the plan. But it is important to not implement too many details. Let's leave some space for creative development later. Focus on what and why, not the how. Next stage is all about technical details. An instruction that will be attached to every prompt for your agents, that will inform in which language you are developing the project, what framework you are using, and basically any guidelines your AI agent should follow. It might be as well your organization coding best practices. I will not go too much into details right now. You can check the guidelines I am currently using for local AI bench. You can find the link in the video description. Alright, we have got our project plan and our technical guidelines. Now it's time to unleash our AI agents. We are going to simulate a real software development team, but with AI doing the heavy lifting. I created documents that describe the goal of each role. I will explain each one, starting with a project manager. Again, you can find all documents in the repository. The project manager is responsible for taking our high-level goals, things we described in the project plan, and changing them into actionable tasks for the rest of the team. Here is the prompt to trigger PM agent. We are explicitly telling it, hey, you are the project manager. This helps the AI stay in the character and produce relevant output. We give it the overall task goal and we are providing the general instruction how the task should look like. It has also role description and project plan attached to each prompt. The project manager, after reviewing the project plan, will generate a future request. Make sure the goal is clear and provide high-level description. Next up is analyst agent. It takes the feature request from the PM agent and digs into technical details. Think of it as the bridge between what and the how. Here's the prompt to trigger Analyst. Again, we are role playing. You are the analyst. We are pointing it to the feature request file and telling it to create a task details file. Analyst output is critical. It's a JSON file, format that AI can easily read and understand very well, containing everything that developer agent needs to implement the task. This includes files to modify, step-by-step instructions, and reasoning notes to explain why certain decisions were made. To prepare this file, Analyst reads the codebase files, analyze them, and retrieve relevant information. Because the analyst has to read the current application state, it must have a large context window. I am using Gemini model to complete this task because its context window is 1 million token length. Finally, we have our developer agent. This agent is the code writer. It doesn't make design decisions, it follows the task details file exactly. Here's the prompt to trigger it. We are pointing it to the JSON file created by the analyst. And there is a critical step, the pre-implementation check. Before writing any code, the developer agent must scan the task details file to check if there are no problems. Maybe some of the instructions are unclear, maybe some things can be interpreted in multiple ways, or maybe different parts of the file contradict each other. If the developer finds any issues, it must request clarification from the analyst. This is a crucial safeguard against wasted effort and errors. Once the developer has cleared complete task details file, it implements the changes exactly as specified. The developer agent's role has some key rules. First, follow instructions precisely, because we don't want any changes that are not required. Secondly, don't create assumptions. If something is unclear, just ask analysts to clarify. And finally, focus on execution. Implement the code, don't make design choices. Developer agent, as the analyst, also have access to entire codebase, but as in the instructions for the role, it only accesses the files that are being changed. It saves a lot of context length and protects us from out-of-token error. For this workflow in GitHub Copilot, I use O3 Mini as a project manager in edit mode, Google Gemini as an analyst also in edit modes, and new Cloud 3.7 as a developer in agent mode. Those creates a powerful iterative process. It's all about the collaboration and ensuring a high quality results. And at every step, you as a human developer can step in and change project plan, parts of the code, or whatever you want. Remember, those agents are only the tools you can use. That's how you can build larger projects using AI agents, turning AI into your development team. It's a powerful way to tackle complex projects, boost your productivity, and most importantly, build better software. What project will you build with this AI workflow? Let me know in the comments. And as always, dev it with me, subscribe for more.